Hi, I'm Colin, and this is Sci-Fi Deep Dive. So I've talked about this before, but the number of questions I got about it makes me figure it probably is worth its own video. In The Expanse, one of my favorite science fiction franchises, its dedication to realism means they have to find interesting solutions to artificial gravity. So today, let's take a look at how they generate gravity in The Expanse. Remember, if you enjoyed this video, head down below and hit that subscribe button. So, as I've mentioned before, The Expanse doesn't have magical gravity like you see in a lot of other science fiction franchises. There's no gravity plating or gravity generators that just make gravity. The Expanse instead generates gravity through Newtonian physics. These are methods for generating artificial gravity that actually would work in a spacecraft designed today. So let's take a look at the two ways that they generate gravity in ships and stations in The Expanse. The first, and probably simplest, is centrifugal gravity. We see this mostly on space stations, and it's been around in science fiction for quite some time. Basically, you end up with a vehicle or space station with a big spinning drum on it. Or maybe in some cases, a spinning ring or a spinning component of some sort. Then, using the outward force of inertia, it'll basically generate 1g in that spinning segment. Sort of like spinning something on the end of a string. In The Expanse, this is very common on things like space stations, where there's not really much movement involved. Generally, the equipment needed to make something large like that spin is bulky, and the whole apparatus is basically too large to put on a ship. On top of that, I can't imagine having a large spinning center of mass on a vessel would make it easy to control. Still, this is the simplest way of generating gravity in space, and probably one of the oldest in science fiction. The earliest one that comes to mind is it's actually in 2001: A Space Odyssey. The space station we see at the very beginning of that movie seems to generate artificial gravity this way. But that's not the only way The Expanse generates artificial gravity. The other way they do it, and the more interesting and unique way they do it, is something called linear gravity. Put simply, the ship is constantly accelerating or decelerating at 1g. Then you build your ship oriented like a skyscraper with the engines at the bottom, the decks running perpendicular to the direction of the force from the engine. The force of the engines adds 1g of acceleration. It would basically be like getting in your car and accelerating it with enough force to push you back in your seat with the same amount of force that gravity pulls you to the ground. Now, if you were to do this in space, you would feel like gravity is pulling you back into your seat. This principle allows ships under acceleration to have this simulated gravity. So you spend the first half of your trip accelerating towards your destination, and then when you reach the halfway point, you simply flip around and decelerate the last half. And when you're decelerating at 1g. Now, there is the maneuver in the middle where the ship flips around that does require everyone to be secured, because for that period of time, the ship doesn't have any gravity. But outside of that little maneuver, for most of the trip, the ship's gonna have 1g of artificial gravity. The other tricky way they get around showing zero gravity in The Expanse is magnets. In The Expanse, most people working on ships, both in the various navies of the show or for transport companies, have magnetic boots. You can actually hear it in the show, there's a little audio cue to let you know that they're locking into the floor with their magnetic shoes. This basically saves them the immense budgetary constraints of filming a show that would mostly be in zero gravity. But still, it generates the illusion of having gravity and allows people to sort of move around as if there was gravity. So definitely, compared to a lot of other science fiction franchises, The Expanse has some of the most unique ways of generating artificial gravity. And if you want to know more about ships from The Expanse, I'll leave a link up here to my video on why I think they are some of the best and most unique ships in all of science fiction. And I want you to tell me down in the comments what you think about The Expanse's dedication to realistic artificial gravity. Do you like it, or would you have preferred them to use something more like what Star Trek or Star Wars uses? And if you enjoyed this video, head down below, hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the bell icon so you can get notified when I upload new videos. So for Sci-Fi Deep Dive, I'm Colin, and I will see you next time.